Welcome back to the bunker, everyone. And today we are going to be putting together our 3090 rig. So what I did was I was thinking about just building it on these racks, but there's just gonna be a million screws. So I decided to use this fold table, and I'm going to get everything all put together in today's video. One thing I do recommend to get if you are planning on building a couple rigs are one of these screw sets that they sell on Amazon. Now, I'm not sure exactly which one this is. I've had it for a while now, but I'm sure if you just search it real quick, you can find something very similar. It's meant for computers, and it has every type of screw you'd probably need on building something like this. The reason why I took this one out is I just realized that this frame actually doesn't come with motherboard screws. So luckily, this set does come with those. So we will be utilizing these. I will be using my little screwdriver set here. And as I said in yesterday's video, we have the processor, RAM, CPU, this 12 GPU motherboard, and of course this supposedly 12 GPU frame, but we will just be using 8. And so I'm gonna start with 4 in today's video, make sure that that's all good. I'm gonna put them all on one side, and then if everything is all good in about a day, tomorrow I will be adding the next 4 along with another 1600 watt EVGA power supply. So of course we will be using our 8 capacitor risers. We already put our custom white LED fans on here. We will be using our GPURisers.com SSDs and our 8-pin white splitters. So enough of that. I'm going to go ahead and get the frame put onto this fold table, get all these things unwrapped and everything, and we will be right back. All right, I have a majority of the stuff down here besides the splitter cables and SSD and stuff. We'll worry about that stuff later. What I am going to do now is install the motherboard mount screws. It looks like there are 6 on here, 1 there, 2 there, another 1 there, and 2 there. So you can see here, they make these all pretty generic so they can fit all different size, you know, motherboards, but it looks like we'll be fine. I think I need these 2, that one, this one, and these 2 right here. So that said, let me go ahead and get the motherboard screws put in. All right, guys, we have the motherboard standoff screws installed. Now we're going to install the motherboard. However, this is a very low profile case. The frame right here. So what I am actually going to do first is install the processor and the CPU cooler on it, make sure that that all fits, and then probably just slide it right in and then secure it. So let me go ahead and get that going. All right, guys, we do have the motherboard installed now. You can tell that we do have a little bit of room left. I am glad that we did get that installed before putting the motherboard in. So kind of just slid it in there and screwed it on. So the next thing that I will be doing is installing our first power supply. I'm just going to install 1 right now on this side right here. The second one will be going over here. But like I said, I will only be putting 4 cards on today. Once I can, you know, confirm that those 4 are working just fine, then I will add the second power supply and also the 4 other cards on this side. So let me go ahead and get this power supply unboxed. So we will be using our little utility knife that we have here to open this thing up. Now we can get this thing all open. Now, if you guys have seen my other videos, you know I am a huge fan of the EVGA 1600 watt power supplies. Now that I'm running my whole farm on, you know, 240 PDUs, I'm not sure if it's necessarily the only power supplies I will be buying from now on. But my whole farm has been running on 1600 watt EVGAs for years now, and that's because each of these come with a different cord in the back than all the other power supplies that are, you know, 1300 watts and lower. It comes with a thicker cord. I think it's like a 12 gauge cable, and they get, you know, they don't get as hot as the other cords do, especially when you're running them at, you know, near the 80%. So I've always kind of just stuck with the 1600 watt power supplies because of that. But like I said, now that I'm running on PDUs, I don't think it's going to be that big of an issue. But for now, we will be using these. This is a 3090 build, so we do actually need to be using these for this one. So let me go ahead and get this open. And let's get this open right here. All right, so there we go. Finally, after getting that opened up, there it clunks down. Now, these are the cables in here. I'm not going to go too much into this. It's mainly just like every other power supply. You have them all here, and here is the 1600 watt power supply. So here we have our 1600 watt power supply, our 9 VGA cables on here. So let's go ahead and get this thing installed right over here. Now it looks like I actually have this piece right here on backwards. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip this thing. All right, there we go. Now that should line up a little bit better. All right, so we have this all firm and snug in there. That is not moving, so now the next thing I'm going to be doing is getting the graphics cards out of their boxes over there and getting the risers out, get the ball rolling on that. So we'll be right back. All right, guys, we got all of the 3090s out here. I am actually going to be plugging in the cables beforehand, you know, just because I don't want to be reaching under them and everything like that. So with this build, what I am going to be doing is each 3090 will be consuming about 280 watts. So obviously, you know, you can't use a 8-pin splitter, even though you could, but it wouldn't be enough to power these. You could really damage the cards, damage your power supply, everything like that. So what we're going to be doing is we are going to be powering these with two dedicated 8-pins from the 1600 watt EVGA power supply, but there will be one going into here, and then here we actually will be using our GPURisers.com splitter cables so that we're able to power this and the riser. So that we don't have to utilize Molex or anything like that. So really we will only need 8 total VGA cables coming from this power supply. And then on top of that, we will be powering our motherboard and powering our processor. And we will need a SATA cable coming out of here to power the SSD, and also a Molex cable to power our 120 millimeter fans right up here. So let me go ahead and get all these cables installed. All right, guys, we have all of the VGA cables in here. These four are direct 8-pin to 8-pin. These four coming off, I did zip tie them, but they were dual 8-pin actually. So I have a splitter cable connected to each of those. So we have a total of 8 dedicated 8-pins to power 4 RTX 3090s. So I got the Molex cable connected to our fans. They are all daisy chained together. It doesn't look so great in this case, but I will do a little bit of cable management later on once everything is working. I do have the SATA cable right here for our SSD, and all of that is plugged in. Our motherboard's plugged in, processors powered. So what I'm going to go ahead and do now is get our 8 capacitor risers all taken out and put together, get them all on here, and then start loading up the 3090s. So let me go ahead and get to it. All right, guys, we have two of these RTX 3090s installed now. It seems like these cables do get awfully close to the fans. They're not hitting, they're resting right on the shroud right there, but that might be an issue. I'm not sure, I'm gonna have to test that out a little bit, but I did zip tie the cables together and that does seem to be helping. I have the SSD all hooked up right here. I just put in the Ethernet cord and I have a power cord running to our PDU. I just wanted to test it with two of these cards real quick. Again, this is a new motherboard. I've never actually used this one before. So I just want to make sure everything works pretty well. So let me go ahead and flip on the power supply back here. And it looks like it has power. All the risers are powered. You don't get the little 1X light. You know, the chips aren't used on these motherboards, so I guess it is kind of nice because you know it's not going to wobble out or anything like that. You can really feel the air coming off these fans here. That's actually going to be great for these Zotac models. These IO plates on these Zotac 3090s are kind of wide open, which goes straight to the radiator right there, and then on the radiator you can see the heat pipes. So this kind of setup here where you're pulling in cold air straight through that is actually really nice. So although they are Zotac cards, I am hopeful that, you know, they'll stay somewhat cool. So it does look like MinerStat is fully loaded on it and the cards are already mining. You can see 222 megahash across two of these Zotac RTX 3090s. I'm sure that will update. That does seem a little bit low, about 111 per card. There we go, a little bit more. So these are kind of conservative overclocks. I'm gonna test, you know, pushing it a little bit more once all of them are on there. But I am glad that we got two of these up. So that said, let me go ahead and get these other two put on. All right, so we have all four of these 3090s plugged in, ready to go. I'm gonna go ahead and flip this on and make sure that they're all popping on and MinerStat's showing up and everything like that. So you can hear that right there was hitting the fan. So it looks like all the risers are good. Go ahead and give it a minute to boot up. See right here, it's still booting up. So let's give it a couple minutes. All right, guys, we are back. It looks like Minersat's API was down for a little bit, but all four of these are now up and mining. It looks like they're doing about 111 each. Let me refresh this a little bit. 445 mega hash over four cards. So that's about 112 each, 111 each, somewhere around there. So not bad. I know it takes a little bit, you know, for these miners to warm up and, you know, reach their maximum hash rate on these cards. These are non-LHRs, the 3090s, but sometimes it just does take a couple minutes to reach, you know, a regular hash rate on these things. That said, the overclocks that I do have on this rig right now are pretty conservative. It's more for stability rather than, you know, complete performance. So I will be tweaking with the memory and try to get these numbers up a little bit. But I am just glad to have these four up and running today. So I know the cables are just everywhere on this. I'm going to actually just leave it like that until the whole thing is built and stable. Then I'll make it look kind of nice. I think I am going to reverse this from the, you know, position that it is now and have it put right there. I can already tell that these cards are throwing off some heat. Like I said, these fans are pulling in nice cool air. However, each one right now is pulling about 290 watts, so they are going to get very hot. So that is why I will keep it on the second rack right there so that it can let all the heat escape up. So like I said, I am just going to be doing these four cards today. I will be adding the additional four Zotac RTX 3090s over here tomorrow. But yeah, I'm happy to have this up and going. We will be filling these in as time goes. I know I have the stuff over here. Really, that should be on like a little workbench. I am gonna get a rolling workbench for tools and stuff like that, and things that I can work on, kind of like how I'm working on this fold table right here. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and clean these up, get these off the rack so that we can start filling them with rigs. We do have a bunch more left. We have three more 3090s up there. We have, you know, a 3060 Ti, a bunch of 3070 Ti's, a 3080 Ti, some 3070 LHRs down there, and we have a whole bunch of the 6600 XTs. And of course, we still have our blinking light, but we will be getting to those very shortly. We'll be filling these in relatively quick, and then we will be adding a third frame rack thing right here, and then I will have a box wall on a rack that's going to go over there. So thank you guys so much for watching. We're excited to keep growing this here and everything like that. Really loving the 240 volt and the high ceilings and everything like that. It really is what is making this 3090 build possible. So I appreciate everyone watching this video. Hit that thumbs up button if you guys like what you saw, and make sure to subscribe if you guys want to see this whole thing keep getting built out. It's going to be a wild time. So thank you guys again for watching. We'll see you guys next time.